So it's an election year in New Brunswick. It's 2018, and the Atlantic Chamber of Commerce made some headlines this past week, giving its demands, its wish list, its priorities for what it wants the new government to do. And of course, it was all about them. Amongst their bullets, one of them was a private sector-driven economy and geared towards growth. Well, think about it for a second. What has been the narrative the past 30 years in this province? Government bending to the wishes of the private sector in order to generate growth and wealth. So where is it? Our GDP hasn't changed for the past 30 years. Our employment rate hasn't changed much the past 30 years. The government's ability to take those new revenues and put them towards debts and deficits hasn't happened the past 30 years. If ever there was an example of a narrative that needed to change, it was this one, in the dynamic between governments and the private sector. Also connected to their press conference from the Atlantic Chamber was the desire to develop natural gas. They want the ban on fracking to be lifted. But where's the homework? Why didn't media do the homework? Consider any story from any Google search about the development of natural gas and oil in the United States. Who are our largest customer for our exports of oil and natural gas? Here's one quote from one story, which is oilprice.com. The production growth rate will turn the United States from a net importer of oil into a net exporter by 2025. It will also become the world's largest LNG exporter that year. Why would the Atlantic Chamber of Commerce encourage a provincial government to look at natural gas development when our largest customer is going to be self-sufficient in the next decade and become an exporter, therefore a competitor? What about all the natural gas and oil that they're currently importing? Where will it go for those markets? There needs to be a shift in the thinking. There needs to be a shift in the narrative. And here's one example of what that shift can be. Imagine what it would feel like if the Atlantic Chamber of Commerce offered this instead of the demands they put on the government. Maybe they should just say what they will do to help make the province better. Maybe they should put pay equity into practice. Maybe they should start creating the jobs and the wealth they claim to want to create over the past 30 years, and it still hasn't happened, even given all these advantages. Maybe they should make wages higher and not wait for minimum wages to be imposed. Maybe they should index a certain percentage of their gross profit back towards community. Don't say it doesn't work, because Ben & Jerry's did it and several other companies do it, B Corps do, so that they take care of their community. Maybe they should have a strategy for retention of immigrant families and workers when they move here. Our province has the lowest retention rate in Canada. And especially, maybe the Atlantic Chamber of Commerce should be grateful for everything everyone is trying to do to help them be successful.